transferred to Liverpool 4 months ago for £110,000. And in the number six shirt, Ian Evans from Crystal Palace, born in Surrey, but with a father from Abercorn, Welsh in his blood. The Austrian side, the side that has been gradually finding some form, and in fact is not going to be any pushover at all. Four of the side coming from Innsbruck, the Austrian champions and cup holders. Their most experienced player in the number 10 shirt, Hans Ettmeier, tonight getting his 30th cap. He's been playing in Germany, first for Stuttgart and now for HSV Hamburg. The referee tonight comes from Italy, Herr Gonella. Wales will have the wind at their backs in the first half, attacking the goal to our left. Players, but of the Welsh crowd. They beat Wales in Vienna by 2-1 in September of last year, but they'll find it a very different proposition here. It's Terry Yorath, the Welsh skipper, and that's long, and all the way through to Friedel Consilia, the Austrian goalkeeper. That's the sweeper, Winkelbauer, back to Consilia. Kreese, the skipper. And the referee calling Austria to get on with it. Yorath to Flynn. And this little lad will fight for that ball in midfield. This is Prohaska now, foot on the ball, only 20 years old, but a player of enormous promise. Steiner getting it through to Prohaska. And he really is tricky on the ball. Bowled over for the second time in the first 60 seconds of the game. Leighton James holds his hand up, the guilty party that time. And this is Robert Sarre to take the free kick. Bad one. Flynn for Wales. Looking for Leighton James, who eludes the tackle cleverly. Austria getting back goal side. Good tackle by Sarre. Flynn. Joey Jones. Smallman on a run. Man at his back, and he was being held. Referee penalising Prepsai, the big number five. Austrians basically playing with three men across the back and Winkelbauer as a sweeper behind them. And that's the position as Yorath stands over the ball for the free kick. Header by Rod Thomas and out by Steiner. Yara. And now a chance for Austria to break. Steiner. Winkelbauer. Kreese giving it to Yara. It's John Mahoney. And Kreese to take the free kick. Ettmeier rather easily robbed by Mahoney. Yorath. It's a bit wide, picking up pace with the wind, but James has it. Coming inside. Foul given against Jones. But I think the Austrians will be looking for Leighton James to come inside, and he'll find that every time he tries to jink inside Sara, he'll find a second defender. This is Sara. Phillips to Flynn. Rode the tackle well, and the second one brings him down. And Steiner, who is a very tough customer indeed, getting a lecture from Mr. Ganella. Terry Yorath just exchanging a few words in what language, goodness knows. Smallman. Smallman's header, and he was fouled. Petsai, number 5, penalised. So Arfon Griffiths has now gone forward onto the edge of the box with Smallman. So too has Little Flynn, number 8 there in that picture. Terry Yorath wanting the 10 yards. Prohaska isn't far enough off, he says. Mr. Canella says, yes, it is. And the shot by Leighton James charged down. Ball very difficult to control. The referee very strict in the early stages. That's John Mahoney, who was penalised then for the second time. They're called back, I think, to take the kick again. Taken with a rolling ball from the gesture made by the referee. This is Ettmeyer to take the kick. Well meant, but well cut out too. Griffiths to Smallman. And that ball absolutely hanging and coming back in the wind. Difficult head off of Phillips, which he did well. Cut through by Crankle, but given away. Winkelbar. Yara. Ettmeyer. And Winkelbar. Ettmeyer lying back as the link man to pick up those throwouts from the goalkeeper. Thomas. Still on the ball. Griffiths' cross. Pulled down by Leighton James. He's through. Can he turn? Joey Jones was crowding him, and I don't think the fullback helped him then. And Leighton James disappointed not even to get a corner. But then, as Leighton James jinked his way through with support from Jones, it looked almost as though Jones was getting in his way, and he could never really turn it back, and the ball just harmlessly ran out. Yorath's header. A free kick given. I think that's Yorath down there. Free kick is against him, nevertheless. It's going to be work for the trainer. Arfon Griffiths in the number 7 shirt being given an interesting role tonight, being expected, I think, to drop through into the open gaps that Wales have left on the right through playing only 2 orthodox strikers. We've seen him go through once or twice already. And the crowd, I think, with their hopes raised a little bit by that incident a couple of minutes ago. Ettmeyer again to take the free kicks. Very much the general at the back. Yara. Brought down by Mahoney, and that's the 3rd foul that Mahoney has committed. The game 8 minutes old. And again, it's Ettmeyer to take the kick. driven hard and a header by Frankel into the arms of Lloyd. He's had to wait a long time for that touch and he'll be glad to have had it. With the wind, enormous kick, Mahoney, and there's Griffiths going in on the right. He's got, no, he hasn't got the corner, it's a goal kick. Francilia, the Austrian goalkeeper, getting his 17th cap tonight. But he's not going to take the kick. That was Crankle penalised for a foul on Evans. It's Crankle, the leading scorer for Austria. Leighton Phillips from Aston Villa to take the free kick. This is Kreis, Winkelbar. Biara, swinging that long, long ball. Terry Yorath, the white armband of the skipper. Thomas, aimed for Flynn, but headed away by Steiner, on by Crankle, Mahoney, and out of play. Etmeyer. One thing that's been worrying the Austrians a little bit is that their only really reliable passer over more than about 20 yards is Yara, wearing a number 11 shirt and playing as an orthodox winger, but really a midfield man for his club. Etmeyer then letting them down with one that went into touch. Here's Crankle now. Steiner going in two-footed for that tackle. Mahoney. Thomas was asleep. Yara. Crankle going through the middle. Number nine is Crankle, sweeping it back out for Yara. Good speed, good tackle by Mahoney. Yara trying again. Pull back for Etmeyer. And easy for Lloyd. Etmeyer's shot then, half blocked, took the pace of it. Petsai's header. Foul given, James on Prohaska. Good header by Phillips. Throw in for Sara to take. Veltzel won't get past Jones at Toei. But the ball's gone out and it's another Austrian throw. Austrians have had a couple of defeats recently in Hungary and in Vienna by West Germany. But up until those two defeats, they'd gone 17 months without being beaten. Trying to get Veltzel going down the right, and Jones slides it over the line. It's Joey Jones of Liverpool, once of Wrexham, very much at home on this ground. Steiner whipping it into the middle, and trying again. Yara, trying to flip it up for a volley, wasn't allowed the room. It's Griffiths back to Phillips. Smallman. Ball very lively and the wind strong, and neither side I think finding it at all easy in these conditions. But what a good ball from Yorup to James, setting himself for the right foot, bent it the wrong way. But Leighton James, given the opportunity there, went at his man, cut inside as he likes to, and when he let go with the right foot, the ball always looked as though it was going to bend outside the post. So Concilia with a goal kick. And again, a slightly sliced kick, but the wind having a lot to do with that. And Wales may well feel that they want to get a goal while they've got this wind at their backs. Thomas floating it in on the wind. Long. Good header by Winkelbar. Mahoney beaten to it by Kreese. But it's going to be Thomas again, and from the way everyone's retreating, it's going to be another whopper. Headed away by Winkelbar, this time for a corner. And that's the first corner of the game. We've been playing exactly 15 minutes. Leighton James to take it. Joey Jones has gone up. So too has Ian Evans. There's Joey Jones, number three. There's Ian Evans, number six. Ten is Smallman. Two on the post is Thomas, and here's the corner curling in. Arfon Griffiths got to it, and it's out for a goal kick. Arfon Griffiths, who was on the far post, but in fact Leighton James may need one or two sighters because the wind very strong. Kreese. Yara, Steiner breaking, and he's won it from Yara, and given out a great ball. Veltzel running onto it, number seven, but a good tackle by Jones. Corner to Austria, but a good timely tackle there by Joey Jones, at his best in that kind of situation. Not the best of distributors, but a great tackler. Arfon Griffiths getting in behind Lloyd on the far post. Yorath there, number nine. Veltzel's corner turned away, and the danger passes for Wales. Good tackle, that was Mahoney. Prohaska. This looks such a dangerous player, so much skill on the ball. Here's Veltzel. Prohaska well marked, and Wales bring it away through Jones. Steiner, Winkelbar, Kreese. Etmeyer, Petsai, Prohaska. Etmeyer again. Yara beaten before he could get to it. Phillips coming in fast and hard. Terry Yorath, and now a throw for Kreese. Winkelbar to Concilia. Griffiths to Mahoney. Flynn at his side. Phillips, Griffiths, Thomas, Mahoney, Smallman is in the middle, Flynn is stealing in there too, needed an earlier cross. This is Yara, Krankel has got the throw and takes it himself. The referee is sending them back. And in fact, he's given a free kick, which Kreese has already taken. Yara. Bad ball. But Smallman unable to take advantage. Winkelbauer encouraged to come forward. Mahoney to Flynn. Player who shows so much awareness of what goes on around him. Down there came Smallman, brought down by Petsai. Flynn very angry. Petsai, the number five from Innsbruck, the Austrian champions. Yorath with the free kick. Mahoney. Phillips under no pressure. Griffiths running into a very good position. Flynn. Mahoney. Tremendous tackle by Petsai. That was off Thomas. And it's an Austrian throw. Flynn back to Yorath. Thomas giving it back to Yorath, and they can't work their way off that touchline. Free kick has been given. Yorath and Thomas in conversation. Yorath's cross. Blocked by Etmeyer to Yara. So many of the continental sides, very neat on the ball. Sara to Prohaska. Flynn, looked like a suspicion of handball there, but the referee says no, play on. Ah, four to cross to. James, just a little chip, header away by Petsai. Yara. And that's the man who gives out the good long balls. Just kept in. Etmeyer kept it in. Mahoney put it out. Etmeyer. Yara to Petsai, on to Winkelbauer. Etmeyer. Mahoney saw the chance, Etmeyer will try again. Oh, too clever. Mahoney, Smallman beaten. Griffiths to Flynn. Needed a quicker ball. Yorath. Thomas steaming up into that gap on the right. And Wales leaving that space empty and getting different men forward on the right. Sometimes Mahoney, sometimes Griffiths, sometimes Thomas. Flynn now. Mahoney. Griffiths. Phillips to Thomas. Smallman. Flynn. Steiner giving away a bad one. Griffiths now trying his luck on the left and succeeding. Sara, very cool and a little bit dangerous. Winkelbauer, no route back to the goalkeeper. Prohaska, Etmeyer, they really are fiddling. And eventually Petsai shields it back to Consilia. Crease. Yara, finding Steiner. Laid off very nicely, and here's Prankel, showed it, and Evans got it. Crease racing back, I don't think you need hurry. Wind was always carrying that out. And we're now midway through this first half, still 0-0. Most of the pressure coming from Wales, but that I think only to be expected in these conditions. Phillips asking for effort. Etmeyer. Put away by Evans. Fetsai, Etmeyer. Beautiful skills by Etmeyer, and then he lost it. Jones, too long. James, and back comes Steiner. Free kick to Wales. Wales have had several free kicks somewhere around midway inside the Austrian half, but they're a little bit difficult to take advantage of simply because the wind is so strong behind them. Difficult to play a delicate chip in over about 20-25 yards. We'll see what Phillips can do now. Might be better played along the ground short to someone like Leighton James, who's calling, goes for the chip. Evans got it but couldn't control it. It's come out to Mahoney. Arfon Griffiths waiting, but it didn't reach him. Nice back heel, giving it to Sara. Looking for Crankle. Yara, beautiful ball for him. Yara going on. Into the side netting, but what a beautiful ball. From the time Crankle got it and Yara set off on his run, that looked dangerous. And when Yara got into the box, he really let fly, but it was beside the post. So relief for Wales. But that did look very dangerous. Anybody's. Rod Thomas will have it for the throw. Leon Evans hasn't entirely, I feel, struck up an understanding with Leighton Phillips on the ball now. Flynn. Nice tuck through for Griffiths. Out now to Mahoney. And a two-footed tackle on him. And it's left crease on the ground, and Mahoney still going, and still. And what is the referee giving now? Free kick to Wales. Crease, to coin a phrase, is creased. He really is in some trouble out there. So as Mahoney came through there, there was a real two-footed tackle jumping in. Mahoney did extremely well to come out of it. Just look at that. Mahoney really did well there, and it looks as though in the end it was Crease who suffered. And it looks very much as though they may be calling for a stretcher for him. Branko Elsner, the Austrian manager, going on, and a substitute warming up. Heinrich Strasser is the man whom one would expect to come on. Strasser warming up. And they're now bringing the stretcher. And this looks like an unhappy end to the evening for the Austrian captain, Werner Crease. And the substitute coming on to join the group there is indeed Heinrich Strasser. Heinrich Strasser, 27 years old, 9 caps, played in Austria's last game against Luxembourg. And he is a fullback, so we can expect him just to do a straight job taking over from Kreis. And the feeling seems to be that Kreis may have a broken ankle. And he really is very obviously in severe pain. And the game restarts with a free kick to Wales, but the referee indicating that it cannot recommence until the injured player has been taken off the field, and indeed the photographers, who are crowding like vultures round the stretcher, have also left. And now Mahoney takes the free kick, runs over it in fact, and Leighton James strikes it, a deflection, and it's gone behind for a corner. Second corner for Wales. The free kick run over by Yorath. Leighton James comes steaming in, hits it hard, there's a deflection, and out it goes for the corner. So Leighton James, who overhit his first one, tries now with his second. That's a better one, near post for Thomas, and his glancing header went right across. Rod Thomas it was at the near post who got the back header in, but it was a hard corner. He, rather than taking weight off it, helped it on. Prochaska goes down. Just a straight collision with Smallman. Arfon Griffiths to Thomas. Yorath to Evans. The through ball looked good, but Griffiths couldn't hold it. Prochaska for Austria. And now Sara wearing the captain's armband. This is Prochaska, and that looked like a kick on Yorath. Good ball by Evans. He was put under pressure with that pass. Ian Evans, and now Lloyd. Winkelbauer in control, but the ball really bobbing about. Mahoney, tucked back for Yorath. And the low balls seem all the time more promising than the high ones. Ettmeier for Austria. Yara. Phillips to Mahoney. And Mahoney brought down by Krankel. Free kick immediately taken by Flynn. James trying his luck down the right, taking on the new man, Strasser. Rides the body check, and his shot cannons off Winkelbauer for another corner. Thomas this time staying back. Joey Jones is going up. So too is Evans. There's Joey Jones, number 3, running up onto the line. He'll make life difficult for Consiglia. And 6 is Ian Evans, who has a good reputation meeting corners. Up he goes, gets under it. Goalkeeper has stayed, and it's bobbing for anyone there. Yorath! Goal kick, and Yorath holding his shin. As the ball came out, he didn't flinch. Perhaps didn't even see the defender coming to challenge. Went for his shot, but got it over the top. The shot from Yorath over the top. So back live with Veltzel. Wales ball. Lynn to Phillips. Smallman, good header. Griffiths. Still Griffiths. Referee's called them back, I think, for handball by Arfim Griffiths. Kick taken by Strasser. Strasser getting it from Yara, and he's now brought down by Thomas. Stecanella gives the kick. Yara leaves it for Strasser. And Strasser leaves it. Etmeyer's kick. Evans got under it a bit too much. Jones got it away. Smallman, Mahoney, Griffiths. Mahoney again, and Griffiths. Smallman calling for one. Flynn here in midfield. Evans breaking. Yorath. Phillips. Flynn. Tackled by Prohaska. Leighton Phillips. Driving Wales through again. Yorath. Thomas forced to turn. Mahoney. Still John Mahoney. Smallman had stayed still and Petsai got it. Thomas. Griffiths header. Winkelbar. Strasser. For Yara. Veltzel in the middle, Crankle there, Prohaska going to join them, but Thomas puts it out for a corner. Only the second corner that Austria have had. The last 10 minutes or so, nearly all the play has been in the Austrian half. And they've now got five men in the Welsh box, including Petsai, the number five. Crankle rose well, but it was well wide. Second header that Crankle has got in, but the direction again not very good. Brian Lloyd has had a fairly quiet evening so far in his first appearance for Wales. Griffiths, Mahoney, Steiner to Prohaska. Such a good player, this. Mahoney. Smallman. To Flynn. Couldn't quite make it. And this now is Sara, who has taken over the captain's armband, giving it to Etmeyer. Griffiths. The racecourse ground trying to lift Wales as Mahoney comes on. Sara getting it back from Prohaska, two-footed into the tackle. The free kick is given to Austria, but these Austrians do tend to jump a bit when they're going for the ball, and there's a yellow card, I think, for Flynn. Not entirely clear who he showed it to, got it up and waved it, but I think it was Flynn. It's Brian Flynn, 5'2". On all heart. Etmeyer letting that hang in the wind. Evans. No need for it to go back. Smallman. Finding it difficult to get away from Petsai. Terry Yorath. Sara. Veltzel keeps it in. Jones picks it up. Leighton James cross. Concilius punch. Mahoney. Into the box he goes. Couldn't get the crossover. It was blocked by Strasser. He's got a corner. I think he was half in a mind to ask for a penalty then. But Strasser got in the way, but I think it was just with his body. This time nobody on the line. Yes, Sir Thomas has gone in there. Tall man to obscure the line of sight for the goalkeeper. Six is Ian Evans. Scored a hat-trick of headers this season for Crystal Palace. And over comes the corner and it's curled. And it's just touched over by Consiglia. And Leighton James beginning to get the range now. He had one that was too long, one to the near post, and that one curling in wickedly as Consiglia just touched it over. Over comes the corner again, and out it goes for a throw this time. The long one from Rod Thomas. Evans is at the near post, but that was all a dummy. Played it short, but lost it. Phillips, the defence coming out, playing for offside, but not succeeding. James, Winkelbar gets there first, and that's another corner. That's Winkelbar, 25 years old, his eighth cap for Austria tonight. Joey Jones and Crankle skirmishing on the line there in front of the keeper as Leighton James drives the corner deep. Knocked back in, the keeper's ball. Yara. Interception by Yara Thomas. Yara. Little bit scared of Mahoney, I suspect. Flynn. Smallman, and through it goes to the goalkeeper. And there's quite a strong drizzle in this wind now. Prochaska. Yara on for Strasser. Strasser, a good cross. Up goes Frankel. Cleared by Jones. And Mahoney. Chance for Wales on the break. Three against three. Ball needed to be in front of James, not behind him. Defenders are now back, but James still running. Mahoney. And that's the goalkeepers. There you can see how this rain is drifting in the wind into the face of the Austrian goalkeeper. Prochaska, out of play. The pace unrelenting, not a classic in terms of the actual football played, but the atmosphere and the spirit so strong. Smallman, Etmeyer, Fetsai, and the goalkeeper. Strasser, Yara, Yara thought the throw was for Wales, but in fact it's Austria's. Strasser in two minds. Free kick given against Smallman for backing into Fetsai. Smallman. Still, that's a bit hard. He's had Fetsai breathing down his neck every time he's had any chance of seeing the ball. Etmeyer to take the free kick. Seized on by Yorath, but Sara plays it comfortably to Winkelbar. Firmly won by Evans. Celia, smarting a very natty pair of gloves. Petsai. Prohaska. And Yara lets that long pass of his go. Could be dangerous in the second half when he's floating them with the wind. And ball given against Ian Evans. And meanwhile, Strasser, the substitute, is looking somewhat indignant. Wind will tend to pull this kick back out. Etmeyer driving it hard, hoping to catch defenders by surprise, looking for a cross. Etmeyer really let fly there with his left foot. Got it into the side netting. And we're now in injury time in this first half. Quite a considerable hold-up while Kreis was taken off. But the Austrians may feel that they've done what they set out to do by holding Wales to level terms while they, Austria, were playing against the wind. A draw, of course, will do Wales, but they may find it more difficult to attack in the second half. Yara. Smallman again with Petsai at his back. Flynn. Sara with the throw. Winkelbauer. Steiner. Petsai with Concilia to help him. Goalkeeper tending not to try to kick. Had one or two unhappy experiences trying to belt this ball into the wind. Etmeyer. Veltzel. This could be dangerous. Veltzel looking for a shot. Veltzel putting it well wide. And there, I think, is the half-time whistle. No, that was a whistle from the crowd. Yes, it was. The referee was asking for the ball. And so they go in with half the game gone and Wales halfway to their objective. If they can keep the score sheet blank, they will be in the quarter-finals. But it will be a tense 45 minutes for them against the wind in the second half. Join us again in a few moments. And welcome back as Wales begin the second half with the crowd behind them and the wind in their faces. And what a wind it is, blowing gusting rain, making conditions, I would say, much more difficult than in the first half. The wind now and the rain a lot heavier than they were. And significantly, Consiglia kicking immediately in the second half, where in the first half he was throwing out. Good header there by Mahoney this morning. Mike Smith, the Welsh manager, has said all along that Wales would not just defend, would not just look for a draw. But I guess that his feeling now is that if they can hold out for another 45 minutes with the score sheet blank, he won't complain. Foul given against Strasser on Griffiths. Heinrich Strasser. And now the racecourse crowd letting their team know that they are here. This is what Welsh crowds are famous for. And they have it in them to lift these red-shirted players. Thomas to Mahoney. In comes Steiner, and down goes Steiner. Holding his knee. Whistle is gone, and that's skirmishing near the whistle. I thought that, yes, the whistle had gone. The referee's calling them back. Some quite unnecessary skirmishing going on between Yara and Mahoney. Finkelbar, Ekmar beaten. Yorath forward to Mahoney. Tackled by Steiner, and Mahoney gets up angrily. But Mr. Ganello was right on the spot. Mr. Ganello telling Terry Yorath not to comment. Fingers to his lips, making quite clear what he meant then. James. Beating the tackle from Strasser and getting the corner off Finkelbar. So James to take the corner. Joey Jones there by the near post. Arfon Griffiths at the far post. Corner swinging out in the wind, helped further out by Steiner. Thomas back in. Referee gives offside. No flag from the linesman. Flynn. Prohaska to beat. And round him goes Flynn and gets the corner. And this time he's going to take it himself. Leighton James staying in the middle. Oh, it's not a corner, it's a free kick that's been given. And Yorath is going to take it. Referee calling the two-man wall back. Over comes Yorath's kick. Header by Petsai, back in by Thomas, helped on by Evans. And Consiglia lets it bounce before catching. Free kick's been given. I think Evans may have been penalised. Petsai. Cut out by Mahoney. Had a tremendous game, Mahoney. And there he's brought down by Petsai off the ball. And the yellow card comes out for Petsai. Referee is now put the card back in his pocket, but makes a note of Petsai's number. Mr. Ganella has kept a good firm grip of what has been a fairly fierce game. Yorath. Ekmeyer's kick cannons off somebody. Smallman can't get a sight of the ball, and Consiglia has it, and Smallman pushes him over. But Sara telling Smallman his fortune. And a yellow card for Smallman. It's the third booking. Flynn and Smallman for Wales and Petzai for Austria. There's plenty for the crowd to discuss. And this game, in effect, death or glory, with so much at stake, inevitably becoming more and more tense as the minutes go by. Sara to Ettmeier. Killed by Krankel. Mahoney. Griffiths. Brave header by Strasser. Forward by Thomas. James. Tried to get Griffiths in. Referee gave handball. Ettmeier. Long and hopeful on the wind. Good header by Phillips. Away by Jones. Yorath penalised for what must have been obstruction. The referee gives an indirect free kick. The sort of obstruction I wouldn't want to run into. Ettmeier to take it. Veltzel. Joey Jones showing him the touchline. Veltzel taking him on. Jones denying him the space. Griffiths there helping him. Nice little bit of byplay there, and Veltzel almost smuggled his way through, but eventually was obstructed and gets the free kick. Prohaska will take it. Now he's going to leave it for Ettmeier. Petzai is up at the back of the box. Yorath marking him. 13 there is Strasser. Strange stub kick. Knocked straight back out. Flynn jumping to get the header. Sara got away with it. Finkelbar's lob in, knocked back out. This is Flynn. And Arfon Griffiths has the throw. Flynn to James, the two Burnley men. On again for Flynn. James coming away from Sara. Onto his left foot, good cross. And very nearly an own goal. Leighton James got in there, got round his man on the outside, pulled across back with his left foot, and as the substitute Strasser dived, he put it just over. So it's a corner for Leighton James. Corner number 8 for Wales. And in spite of having the wind against them, they contrive to maintain the pressure. Bandit will just pass the post. David Smallman, I think it was, with the shot. Smallman hitting it as it dropped with his right foot. The corner swinging wide from Leighton James as it dropped, hit by Smallman. So, back again. Griffiths hunting. Ettmeier for Austria. Ettmeier again. Yara beaten, Flynn bravely in. Mahoney under his own header, letting it drop, and the back heel was from Ettmeier, and now Wales can cool it down. Strasser misjudged it. James. Chip. Play on, says the referee, and now there's obstruction. And the free kick is given, but I think the referee may want to have words with Steiner. Yes, he wants Steiner, and I think he's going to book him. Yes, he's got the yellow card out. Or has he? No, it's just a lecture, but not a booking. Steiner, a little bit lucky there. If his trip had actually taken, I think he would probably have been booked. Referee gave him the benefit of the doubt. So Terry Yorath has the free kick. That wall is no more than 6 yards out as Thomas runs in over Smallman's head. Griffiths. Tackled by Winkelbauer, and here's Sara. Yara. Prohaska. Shot cannon off a defender. Back in again by Steiner. That was Yara's shot, but he was offside. Really didn't matter. Linesman standing with his flag up. So Yara put through, and very clearly in an offside position. And in fact, anyway, his shot was well wide. Thomas, Griffiths, and Thomas again. Smallman, Flynn, James. Wales now with seven men forward. Can James keep possession? He's obstructed. Leighton James flat out. Referee saying get up. No sympathy from Mr. Ganella. And the crowd aware, I'm sure, that time is important as the scoreline. Leighton James letting go again, but once again the wall is firm. Jones. That was a wild tackle then by Petsai, and it's left Phillips down holding his knee. James. Referee has called them back. Phillips on his feet but limping back into position. Slayton Phillips. Wild tackle he was a victim of. Prohaska. The two eights, Prohaska and Flynn. Good ball by Prohaska and good running by Sara. Smallman, Petsai's header. Not a very good one by Phillips, but I think he may still be labouring a bit on that leg. Here's Strasser, but it was a foul throw. Yara was the culprit. Wales will benefit. Mahoney, along the line for Griffiths, back inside for Mahoney. Yorath. Spreading it out for Leighton James. Chance for him to take on his man. Pulled it back and it was headed away by Winkelbauer. For an attempted trip on Leighton James. And Terry Yorath indicating something to the referee. Yes, I think it is that Leighton Phillips is in trouble and is likely to go off. the meantime, the referee is saying, get on with it. James takes it and it comes back and he'll take the throw-in. Phillips soldiering on. Leighton James stopped in full flight again. Winkelbauer was the tackler. That was Sarah giving a pass which was well snapped up by Mahoney. A deflection off Fetsai. Smallman looking for support. He's got Griffiths with him. This is Griffiths 7. Ettmeyer didn't get it cleanly away, but Steiner will. Prohaska back to Steiner. And out for Veltzel. Not seen much of him in this half. Flynn. James, Smallman on his own in the middle. Flynn going to join him, and James's body checked again. Robert Asara, the guilty party in that collision. Word of consolation from his skipper for Leighton James. Six there is Ian Evans, seven Arfon Griffiths, 10 Smallman. And Yorath floating in the free kick again. Evans gets it, Consilia's catch. And a charge on him from Flynn. Must have felt intimidated by that. Thomas. Smallman beaten by the ball in the wind. Ettmeyer. A misunderstanding, in goes Frankel. There was a misunderstanding there between Thomas and Evans, and as the ball came in they both rose for it, collided, and as they collided the ball ran loose. Frankel saw it and hit it over the top on the half volley. So we're back live for Lloyd's goal kick. Mahoney, who really has been a star for a while. Oh, no, that was Jones, I beg his pardon. James to Flynn. Dancing down the line there, trying to get Leighton James away again. The two Burnley men have had a good understanding, and James has had a great service from the little inside forward. Defence nicely, but there was an interception by Smallman. Yorath to Griffiths. Smallman moving right. And in comes Fetsai straight away. Here's Mahoney. Smallman. Ettmeyer, read by Thomas, but he couldn't control it. Ettmeyer switching direction now through Sarah. And Sarah hits the long ball, and it's too long, too far, and Yara can't make it. Griffiths. Veltzel keeps it in. No, he doesn't.
Mahoney. Oh, good play by Mahoney. Nudge, put him off balance, gets the free kick. Minutes of this second half gone, still 0-0. Phillips takes the free kick. Knocked off Flynn's foot, and dangerous kicking is given. Away by Yara. Both sides appealing, and the referee has given it to Wales. Looks as though we might see substitutes on from both sides. Meanwhile, the game is pretty warm itself in the middle. Has taken the kick. Evans was under it. Prochaska out. And Sara was caught dwelling on the ball. Mahoney, shirt smothered in mud. Flynn chasing as though he was as fresh as the moment he came on the field. Rain sweeping across this pitch. Vile conditions for football. Thomas, Flynn, James. This is promising, but Petsai is across fast. Finkelbauer for once lured forward, and it looked as though James had got past him, but Petsai was covering. Finkelbauer, Griffiths, pursued by Steiner. And there's another player in some trouble, that's Manfred Steiner, who's one of the hard men on this Austrian side. Flynn. Flynn's cross, that looks good. Yarra's little flick to Thomas. And here's Griffiths. Yes! Recalled to the Welsh side by Mike Smith when he played in Vienna and scored a goal there, really showing himself to be the scourge of the Austrians. Mahoney. Mahoney to Griffiths. Still not clear. Very cool by Sara. Good header by Evans, but a foul given against him. That really does seem to be a fairly hard decision. Evans just backpedaling, trying to read that ball through the wind, but the referee spotted something, and a free kick from there with the wind behind, and a man who strikes it as hard as Empire does really might be something dangerous. Hans Empire saying that the wall is not 10 yards back. This is the man who plays for HSV Hamburg, Empire. And he's not going to take it. It's been played for him. And now he drives it and it hits the wall. Smallman was in the way. And the second attempt was put wide. So the kick just rolled sideways for Etmeyer. It hit Smallman, came bouncing back out, and the second attempt gave Brian Lloyd no pangs at all. We are live again with Lloyd waiting to take the goal kick. Arrangement in the Austrian side, they seem to be pushing Sara, the skipper, forward a bit. The number two shirt in the middle there. Yara. Mahoney to Thomas. Griffiths with a quick throw, Mahoney chasing it, Strasser leaning on him. And now bringing him down. Well, there was nothing very cultured about the way John Mahoney was brought down there. Strasser first leaned on him and then sided him. That Smallman in the middle there, the defenders clustering round him. Flynn. Still going. Good cross, back header was by Petsai. Mahoney is chasing, lobbing it back in. They were wondering about offside, but they were all on. Goalkeeper's come out, got to it. Brave work there. But that little overhead put Concilia in trouble. Etmeyer. Thomas. James. Foul given on Crankle by Yorath. The two nines meeting on the touchline. Russell takes the free kick. Yorath side foots it. Saro seems to have given himself a roving commission now. Wins that well. But Empire wasn't running. And Yorath brings down his man and is booked. And he's now deep in conversation with Yara. Whether Terry Yorath speaks German or whether Yara speaks Welsh, I'm not quite sure. But I don't think there was much doubt that they understood each other. Etmeyer. Mahoney and a corner. Brian Lloyd organising the men in front of him. Brian Flynn takes the near post. Griffiths on the far post. Thomas just in front as the corner comes over from Yara. Back in it goes, but over. No luck for Crankle. Lloyd's kick really hanging here, but Mahoney under it, Flynn helping it further forward. Less than a quarter of an hour to go now. Wales leading 1-0 and in the driving seat. Leighton James, run off the ball by Etmeyer. Thought better of it and just as well. Imagine that sign is universal too. James, Mahoney, and away he goes. What a storming game Mahoney has had. James. Let the man have a look at the ball, and Winkelbaar took advantage. John Mahoney. Etmeyer, Prohaska. Great ball, Steiner on. Well, that was Sara playing it back. Winkelbaar now has to get it going in the other direction. Gets a return pass, he could have done with that. Another throw for Wales. Jones. Yorath. Smallman penalised for backing into his man. Well, at least the referee wagged a finger at him, didn't actually give the free kick. Evans. Mahoney to James. Strasser a little bit lucky, but took advantage of it well. Etmeyer. In goes Mahoney. Free kick given. Unceremonious and certainly illegal challenge. Sara. Steiner let it run. Stering. A substitute who's not had a great deal of the ball since he came on. Now Prohaska. Now Sara, chance for him to shoot. Got away by Evans. Yorath thought about Lloyd and then changed his mind. Thomas. James setting off on one of those powerful runs. And a good interception by Strasser. Mahoney, strong and tireless. And over goes Flynn as Bedside tries to wrestle the ball away from him. The Austrians frustrated by what they clearly see as time-wasting by Wales. Mr. Canella saying, I'll do the timekeeping. You get on and play the football. Etmeyer. Smallman. David Smallman. disappointing end to for Smallman, who hasn't had many opportunities to take the ball facing the Austrian goal. He's mostly had to have it with his back to goal and Petzai breathing down his neck. Prohaska tripped. Smallman gives him a look that says, I know just how you feel. Petzai did well and comes on with it. Thomas to James. And past his man he goes. Sara it is, doubling back with help from Winkelbar. Sara again, Petzai, Sara. It's as though he might have been wasted at fullback, Sara. He's done so well since he's come out of that back four. Flynn. Steiner, man who's covering up right back to let Sara come out. Griffiths, that's a great ball, not quite accurate enough, but Mahoney, and on for James. Look at the speed. Round his man, but he's pushed the ball too far. It's a corner. Concilia came out to smother it, and on the slippery top, his impetus took the ball over the line. Linesman was well placed, and Leighton James, if I am any judge, will not be in a hurry to get out there to take this corner. We've got 8 minutes to go. Wales, on one of the great nights in their history, leading Austria by 1-0. Evans didn't quite make it. Flynn taking on Prohaska, and Petzai puts it out for a corner on the other side, and there'll be a slow walk for Leighton James. No, Flynn is willing to take it. Six is Evans, 10 Smallman, 7 Griffiths. Flynn with the corner. Evans up well, goalkeeper catches. Ian Evans, a long run back now. I suppose that in these conditions, with a 1-0 lead, you don't feel it, but you can guess how the Austrians feel. Soaked to the skin and a long way from home, and a goal down. Etmeyer. That was a brave header. Yara was in chasing, but Lloyd has not really had a direct save to make all through the match. Yorath. Mahoney. Flynn. Steaming through. What a little player this is. And over he goes. James. Better by Mahoney. The goalkeeper can let it go. John Mahoney, really one of the stars for Wales, but nobody has let them down. Strasser. Good ball from Yorath. Smallman run out of it, but chasing hard. Although we've seen very little of David Smallman, he's one of those players who only needs half a sight of the ball to let fly, and is not a player that the Austrian defence can afford to neglect. The free kick for the foul on Smallman to be taken by James. Evans met it, Etmeyer got it away, but only as far as Mahoney. to Flynn. Boyo is always making himself available. Mahoney. Jones. Good cross. Keeper caught that well. Coming on the wind, in the rain. Consilia limping a bit. Mahoney driving forward again and getting a clip across the back of the legs for his trouble. On for James. In goes Winkelbar and out goes the ball for a corner. Wales now not to be denied, and the Austrians becoming dispirited, just finding that the spirit of Wales is too much for them. Just listen to this crowd. Too high for Evans that time. Flynn waiting. Ups a daisy. Back heel for him. Well stopped by Petsai. Sara. Dwelt on it, lost it to James, gets it back. Prohaska. Three minutes now to go. Phillips getting it back to Lloyd. A happy night for Brian Lloyd and his international debut. Crowd now in happy mood. Well, they might be. Griffiths. Strasser. Sara. Frankel's header, Steiner chasing it, Thomas with him, and saving it from going for the corner. Rod Thomas of Derby, and now less than 2 minutes to go. Brave header away. Flynn. James. Two against four. Griffiths coming up in support. And James tackled and stopped by Winkelbar. But all the while the ball is in the Austrian half. That's all that Wales need now. The draw would have done them. 1-0 is a real bonus. Mahoney just a bit too hard. Catching Arfon Griffiths on his heels. We're in the last minute. 60 seconds from glory for Wales. Yorath to Griffiths. On for James. Muscles in their legs must be aching. With the effort they put in, ploughing across this wet pitch, which I may say has stood up very well in the conditions, but they'll not feel the aches tonight. 15 seconds to go. Wales 1, Austria 0. And a place beckoning in the quarter-final of the European Championship. And there is the final whistle. Wales have done it. What a tremendous performance. Mike Smith said that his team would not be satisfied with a draw, and that has been borne out. Arfon Griffiths, the scorer of the goal, but 11 heroes on that pitch. The final result at the racecourse ground, Wales 1, Austria 0, and Mike Smith, the first man on the pitch, to congratulate Griffiths. John, I've also asked for Arthur. Arthur Griffiths. Yes. Alan is already on his way down. Yes, I will. Okay, thank you.
Cheers, Dave.
Oh, shit.
I left this all fucking done. Oh, just pull it apart.
Oh,
I guess it.
The one with the blue on it.
Not that one.
Do it. Take it out of the way.
That's it.
All right, I hope you can hear me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's some level. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 level. Are they bringing a def 8 for me? I've got an end if you have. Pardon?
You ready?
Yes, running in very often.
Is that supposed to be?
I don't know. I mean, are they bringing me something or are we going to do it? Yes, they've got. I've got an end. I've got my own end.
Just
going to
use this one.
We don't need it, apparently. They won't really
do it with that. Okay, will you count me then?
Sorry. Oh, okay.
Count me then, will you? Count me. A great night for Wales, beating Austria by 1-0. And a really tremendous performance under the most difficult conditions imaginable. A fierce wind blowing straight down the ground and torrential rain on top of it. It was 0-0 at half-time, and Wales had the advantage of the wind then. Against the wind, one really wondered whether they would be able to hold out, because the Austrians had looked neat, even though they'd lost their skipper Kreese with a broken leg. But in the second half, Wales found their energy and their spirit redoubled. They had mounted attack after attack, and when Yorath let the ball go to Thomas, Thomas slipped it through the middle, and little Arfon Griffiths, 34 years old, slammed home the goal that took Wales into the quarter-final of the European Championship.
For him,
but I don't know whether he's...
We've asked for him, but he hasn't arrived yet.
I mean, we can go without him, if you like. Do it without. No. We then let Mike get away. Shall we do it without?
All right.
Yes, thank you, Leslie. All fine.
Don't want anybody else.
I think they're trying to get Arfon, but I don't know how soon we'll...
We won't get him.
No, we won't get him. Don't worry, forget
camera
it.
Camera 4, fine. Okay.
Leslie, when you go in then, will you tell them not to worry about Arfon? We'll
yes,
manage
sir.
With that.
Okay. Can you come slightly?
Yeah.
Okay, there.
Okay.
Right, it's Shade Moore again, sorry.
Right.
Sorry. Okay, close again.
Right.
We got 2 shot on 3.
Yes.
Which is the camera which was on the previous platform there.
Right.
Shot there.
Okay.
And a close-up of Mike will be on 4.
Okay.
Arfon's quite happy to do it once he's had a bath.
No, I think we'll... Not to worry. Forget
okay.
it. We'll do this now because then we can let Mike get away.
They want 3 minutes from Mike.
Yes.
On his
and then,
own,
and then
and
a
2
quick...
minutes if we got Arfon, but we haven't got him.
No, we won't get Arfon. So what do they want?
No, we won't have Arfon. No.
Now...
So, if you can...
Yes.
There we are.
And do they want me to do a wrap-up at the end of it?
Yes, please.
So... Thank you and good night at the
thank
end.
You,
okay,
night,
all right, will do. And do that to there or to the low angle?
To camera 3, which is the...
Do the wrap-up to,
yes,
to there,
please.
All right.
Well, 4 will be really on the system.
We'll just be on the mic,
yes.
Okay.
Where are we
you.
Looking?
That camera, oh, well, I mean sort of more, you know, between me and the camera, that'll
yeah.
work, do you? Right, ready when you are.
Okay. Can I?
Yes. I feel with so much wind that we're having a bit
okay.
of a
problem. Okay. Yeah, I'll just do a fraction to camera
fraction to camera.
Bring Mike sort of in virtually at once.
Okay.
Ready when you are.
Is he working with him?
Well, no need to emphasise what a tremendous performance that was. And no need either, I'm sure, to say that the most popular Englishman in Wales tonight is Mike Smith. Mike, congratulations. Did that go according to plan?
Well, the lads played tremendously, particularly in the second half. This first half, we tended to hold on to the ball at the back. It was very difficult because the wind behind us kept floating the ball away. And as you saw in the second half, that Leighton James was far more dangerous with the ball sticking to his feet rather than running away, where they could get a toe in to knock it into touch.
Yes, you had a number of free kicks about sort of 10 and 15 yards outside the box in the first half, which were difficult to use, weren't they?
Well, yes, because the ball floated in the air and went away from people. In the second half, they were much easier, really, surprisingly, to play against the wind. Often happens that way, doesn't it?
There was some tremendously fierce tackling, particularly in the first half.
Yes.
By both sides?
Yeah.
I mean, fair, but,
well,
but very fierce.
A lot at stake, you see,
yes.
And you can't afford either side to draw out of these things. And, you know, the referee was in control.
I thought, in fact, he did a very good job.
Very good, very yes. good. If we had referees like that all the time, then, you know, you can play it hard, you can play it fair.
It did seem to me that a lot of your success stemmed from the ability of your ball winners in the middle of the field.
Oh, yes, but I mean, in the second half, we're also able to play it. And once you get it, you don't give it away. And this is really the essence of it. The passing was very good and immaculate at times, and considering the conditions.
I was a bit concerned that you went in 0-0 at half-time and then had to face the wind.
Were you? Well, what we had to do was to convince the lads that, in fact, they had it all to do then, and to calm down, they got over the tensions and the fear of losing, which is in fact an important one when they're so close to it. And we felt that if they just calmed down and pushed forward and supported and helped and so on, and we took the tension out of it. You know, we just really offhand about it and just relaxed them and let them come out and play. You see, Terry Yorth had a tremendous blow on the nose. The doctor's checking now whether it's broken in the first 5 minutes.
What about the new caps, Mike?
Oh. Well, Brian Lloyd froze, so that it's very difficult to judge him, because
yes.
they didn't really come into our half to do any shooting. Ian Evans was immaculate. You know, he was winning balls in the air, and he was composed on the ball, and filled in so well, I thought. I was pleased with his performance. Joey, well, what can you say? Every